that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, she may come before your face. Per Dominum Jesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivis et regnas unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hands of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem in view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was taught an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. May they are in peace. For if before men, indeed, they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate them one from another, as the shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. A stranger and you welcomed me. Naked and you clothed me. Ill and you cared for me. In prison and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for the one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison, and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison and not minister to your needs?' He will answer them, 'Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, God is good. We have every reason to thank God, even though we mourn and we weep, because we are celebrating the transition into glory of a woman, a mother, who has lived to ripe old age, and who has left a legacy for humanity. A few days ago, I came across one of the short videos circulating on the social media, and somebody was blaming the church, our church, the Catholic Church, that we are told to venerate the saints, yet the church refuses us from venerating our ancestors. That means the church is telling us that we give big name for saints then, because they are in plenty, most of them, and then they tell us that we don't give big name for we own ancestors. And I said, no, the church has never refused us from exalting our ancestors. But we ourselves, Africans, sometimes we lack the courage to venerate our ancestors. Who are ancestors? Ancestors, briefly speaking, are those friends and relatives, brothers and sisters, and parents of ours who have lived good lives, who have lived righteous lives, and they have passed into glory. And for us Africans, just like the Catholic Church teaches, at death, life is not ended. It is a transition. That is why we celebrate the resurrection. Today, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, I find it a privilege to stand to testify in the homily that Mami Fanda, Mary Fanda, popularly known as Mami Pap, is a woman, or was a woman, who lived according to the divine expectation. Amen?
Amen.
We are gathered here today because of our faith in the resurrection. Our faith teaches that those who live righteous lives live in the Lord. That's why the first reading of today tells us that the soul of the righteous lies in the hands of the Lord, and no torment will ever touch them. The implication here, my brothers and sisters, is this, that the soul of the unrighteous lies somewhere else. It surely lies in the realm of the prince of evil. The gospel text of today talks about the last judgment, and the text presents the last judgment in a very practical way. Jesus does not judge us in a vacuum. He does not judge us in some abstract or ivory tower perspective. Jesus judges us the way we relate practically with one another. Jesus is present, as he tells us in the gospel, in those who suffer, those who are in need of our assistance. The people will ask the king on the last day, "Lord, when did we see you hungry, naked, in prison, or in the hospital, and did not come to your assistance?" Then the Lord will say, "Insofar as you neglected to do this for the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you refused to do it to me. Conversely, insofar as you did this to the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did it to me." We are celebrating a lady, a woman, a mommy who was open to the public. She was a staunch member of the St. Jude Apostolate, and I see many of you lying there in your uniform. We are so proud of you. When you come out, you identify, just as I see the Catholic Women Association and other groups. Like my father of blessed memory, Papa Sede, Mami Fanda made sure that all of her children, I can say us her children, our parents used to gather us time and again. I remember people like Michael, Louise, in our old age group, whether you like it or not, you had to go to church. And sometimes after Mass, no matter how hungry you are, you go for the St. Jude meeting. Sometimes it doesn't matter where you went on Saturday in the evening. That was not their business. You can't sleep outside. But on Sunday in the morning, you must go to church. There was no, you could not negotiate that. And that's why, by God's grace, some of us are where we are today. Mami was famous and consistent, not only with the sales of her pap that gave her the name Mami Pap, but sometimes when we went even for some of those St. Jude meetings, after that, they will move from one house to another to visit those who are sick, not only to pray, but sometimes to give food and to attend to their domestic needs if there were no people in the house. When I think of Mami Pap, whose funeral we are celebrating, I think of many of the other women in those days who owned businesses. You know, she is called Mami Pap for those who do not know, because she used to sell pap. That was a common business. That is not as if she was the only one, but she did her own in an extraordinary way. You know, St. Teresa, we are told, tells us that we do the little things in an extraordinary way. She was famous in the way she related with the public and with other children with all her simplicity. Sometimes we ask ourselves how some of our parents survived when we were growing. I'm talking because while she was selling pap, some other mommies around us whose children I see here were selling puff-puff, my own mother owned puff license. Sometimes even us who used to assist them in selling, we were not straight, you know. Sometimes it's like when they are a little distracted, you know, already eat a bit of pap or take one or two bottles of maybe alcohol or sweet drinks, then you pinch some of the money and put in your pocket. But they were still surviving. And then some of them even had to close what they call false talk. I don't know how mommy pap survived until the end. Because I remember that even as far as the time that I was principal of St. Francis College, sometimes mommy pap would come with the grandson, David, holding her in the hand. After the mass, she would say, "Father, your pap never come at all." Sometimes she would say, "Father, when you get a chance, pass your house, can't chop small pap." Mommy was consistent in that business because she did it with a clean heart, and God blessed her in her business because of her outreach to humanity. Amen?
Amen.
Sometimes even like somebody also who stood behind the counter to assist my mother to sell, and like somebody who associated with the founders as they were assisting their mother to sell, people came to borrow. And people who came to borrow did not come out of bad faith. It's because they were actually hungry. Sometimes when they borrow, you can write somewhere payment before service, and they will confuse you with some nice talk. Before you realize you have given them pap or you give them whatever to eat or drink. Before you realize they search their pocket, "Oh, I forget money for house." But they had actually come to borrow. After 2 weeks, they are not passing along that street again. They take the drink. Not because they wanted to punish you, the vendor, but they had no way. That for them was a survival strategy. And the Lord tells us today, "I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty, you gave me drink. And I was in prison or in the hospital, you visited me." These are the small acts of charity that made our parents famous. These are the acts of charity that we are celebrating today in the life of our mother. And as the church teaches, the souls of the righteous lies in the hands of the Lord. How else do we know somebody who is righteous? By the way you open your heart to humanity. I remember when I just came to the United States. I know each person has his own or her own story. It was difficult to me. I was somewhere living with them in a presbytery with some white priests. So the food there was really difficult to me. One evening I told myself that I will have to eat. Fortunately, we had passed through a food aisle. So I saw they were selling croissants, bread, and those things. I saw how good. So in the evening, I just moved out of the house. It was not far. Walked there. And I realized that they had locked there. It was like 9:30, 9:45. It was locked. So I saw there that it was closed. But I realized that people were still inside. So I asked somebody standing, they said, "No, when they close," I think it's the same thing even today, "when they close, you can, those who are in can go out, but those who are out cannot go in." And I was really hungry. I said, "Well, make I use my fear, no sense." As someone was getting out, I sneaked myself inside. So it was already getting to like 10 o'clock. I never knew that the person who was selling saw me and she was smiling. I never knew I picked my bread, my son, a few things. When I came, she told me, "Sorry, my brother, I know you are really hungry. I could have helped you, but there is even no way I can run your thing because the machine has shut down." So even if I have sell for you, I'm not feeling sell for you because the machine or the not close. Then I think about Mami Pap. If I were a fiango, even in the middle of the night, you knock at that door that you want. They will send you the map, not because they needed the money, but they know that you are
hungry.
Then I see some of my friends sitting in front of me. There was a famous bar around there they call Alimentation San Maris. Unfortunately for the founders, it was just beside the house. So when some of us go there, before you go and start enjoy yourself there, you've got to pass to greet Mami Pap. Not that you're actually going to eat, but you know that once you get in there, you must get some pap. And often the pap will not come alone. It will be accompanied by some beignet of puff. You know your stomach very well. I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. So now you get into my kingdom. We are celebrating the life of somebody who was open-hearted, a woman who was charitable, and the charity continues to flow in the family. Because I remember when some of us went to Bamenda, we discovered that Sister Stella found I was there. That's where we were surviving. If I had outings in the seminary, there's no way I will not go there, because I know that going back to school, my transport money was guaranteed. They say plum tree only come up for on top orange, it must come under for plum. So that is the family we are talking about. And I have no doubt that Danny, the grandson, ended up where he is on the altar of the Lord. Because Mami Pap was consistent in her morning mass duty. Not only Sunday, every morning she is there, even when she was old. And our grandson, we called her grandson because she had grown out of the quarter long ago. So she would come and leave the children there for vacation. Every morning, Mami would hold Danny's hands and they would come to church. And Danny would not cease asking all types of questions about the priesthood. And that's how why we have him today. So we thank God for you, Father Danny. And we know that your grandmother was a channel to your vocation. God calls us in so many different ways. And that's why, as all of you know, she was particularly attached to Father Danny. Today, we pray, because we know, as St. Paul tells us in the second reading of today, that I have fought a good fight, I have run the race, and now I am waiting for the crown of righteousness. We know, since the souls of the righteous lies in the hands of the Lord, and we stand here to testify to somebody who did her best. Like every human being, Mami must have made her own mistakes. May we leave that God's judgment, and we pray with all faith in Jesus that she will continue to rest in the resurrection of the Lord, because she did her own best. Mami, may your soul and the soul of our Father who had gone earlier and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen. We pray for the Pope, bishops, priests, deacons, and religious as we anticipate the resurrection of the Lord on Easter. May they give witness to this great event by their leadership and the way of life. Lord, hear us. Laws to promote the common good for all people. May they be granted the grace and prudence they need to lead people in fairness and justice. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For Mami Mary Fanda, who has left us to join the angels and saints in heaven, we thank God for the motherly role she provided to all she encountered. May she, who was washed clean in baptism and nourished with the bread of angels, be received by the angels and saints into the kingdom of heaven. May they find rest in the eternal kingdom of God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the bereaved, as they mourn their beloved sister, mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother, may they be consoled by the fact that she lived a faith-filled life. May God's spirit of consolation dwell in their hearts and inspire them with the hope of eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Oh,
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May God accept the sacrifice at your hands for the grace and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Vignette, O Lord, we pray to your servant Mary, on whose funeral we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have come to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. Et Dominum Jesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivis et regnas unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Church, be pleased to grant her peace to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Wilton, our Bishop, his auxiliary bishops, and all those who are holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Gladys, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John, and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through the merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, his almighty God, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Living bread, living bread, living bread. Oh, living bread, comes from the Savior. Oh, living bread, comes from the Savior. Those who eat it have eternal life. Those who eat it have eternal life.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
I will lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher.
Above all the names,
I will lift your name higher.
I will lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher.
Mysterium Fidei.
This spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, especially Mary, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, and may us beseech you into their company, not weighing our merit, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, have mercy on me.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Mary, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
So we have the St. Jude Society now saying the antenna in honor of Mama. After that, we will have the biography of Mama that will be presented by the grandson, Conrad Achi. And then we'll have a vote of thanks from the chairman of the Cameroon Catholic Community here, Resurrection Parish. So let's get the anthem from the St. Jude Society. Thank you.
We
Those candles, please turn them off so we don't spill the wax on the carpet. Thank you, Comrade. And after this, the chairman of the community will be giving us a word of thanks.
Good evening.
Good evening.
For those of us who have the booklet, you can please stand to page 3 to read along with me. Marie Marie Dongwe Fanda was born on December 15, 1943 in Bana, in the west region of Cameroon, to late Tel Bene, Tunde, and Mama Magdalene Kako. When Marie Marie was very young, her family moved to Hausa Quarters Kumba, where Tel Bene became a college tailor in a secondary school located in Kake Kumba. She grew up in a staunch Catholic family as the oldest of 6 children. She received all her sacraments of Christian initiation at Sacred Heart Catholic Church Bengal, now a cathedral where she remained a long life parishioner. She attended and graduated from St. Teresa Catholic School, SCS, in Pembo Kumba. She would eventually meet her future husband, Brian John, and Fender of late, who hails from the western region of Cameroon, the Bad Lamina, but moved to Kumba as well for further education. Late by, John Fender was a customs officer and a farmer. They got married at the then Roman Catholic Church funeral. He would be her life companion until he eventually passed on to glory in 1998. She raised 8 children, 3 girls and 5 boys. One of the girls, Henriette Fender, who was the 5th child, passed away in 2012. Shortly after the birth of her second child in 1960, Mamie Fanda started producing and selling pap. Everyone in Kumba, who especially knows her as Mamie Pap. She would engage in the pap business so passionately until 2021, when she visited her daughter Stella and Chidi and family at the United States. She lived in the United States for a year and 4 months before deciding to visit Cameroon in order to take a break from the winter season. While in Cameroon, she became ill, and the Lord decided to call her home on March 5th, 2023. Mamie Fanda, alias Mamie Pap, was known for her very warm personality and smile. She is a mother not just to her 8 children, but to hundreds. She prayed the rosary and other devotional prayers daily, attended mass daily, and was very active in Central Apostolate. She leaves behind 7 children, 40 grand and 20 great-grandchildren to mourn and celebrate her legacy. Thank you very much.
To Christ.
To
Mary.
To Jesus.
To Mary.
To Jesus.
Mary Stella Maris.
Jesus Christ.
Mary Stella Maris.
Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's also not very familiar with the St. Jude salutation. But on behalf of the Fanger and Chidi families, and Father Denny, on behalf of the Cameroon Catholic community, just really want to thank you all for joining us tonight for this celebration. The homily was very heartwarming. I personally did not know Mamie Mary, Mamie Pap, but what a tribute, Father, your homily was, what a testimony of a life very well lived. From engaging in an ordinary activity, it's just seemingly ordinary activity, it's just selling pap. And as St. Therese says, engaging in an ordinary activity in a very extraordinary way, and with love, with so much love. And your presence here tonight is just a testimony of your life, very well lived, very well lived. And may it give all of us strength and encouragement in our own journey. And what a befitting time during Lent, in a time like this, when we turn inward and during the Lenten season and get prepared for the beginning of Palm Sunday at the start of Holy Week. To have a testimony like this, I call it a testimony, not a homily, woman who stole power. And here we are. Here we are to celebrate. Not a surprise to see that Master through her service in the CWA and her son, our father, our brother, our son, Father Daniel now, who has become our father. And by adoption, we have all become members of the Chidi and the Fana family, right? Because he's a priest. So we gather here as a family, and it's one family. And even though Father Daniel is all the way, since far, I mean, you're not far, you're always so close. And thank you all for coming, and it really warms my heart that the family gathered. And it seems we have some guests who came along to join this family. This family that is the community from which Father Denny comes from. You all remember with joy the journey from the diaconate ordination to the priestly ordination, and the trip that a lot of us took to Buffalo for that event. And from that moment, from that day onward, he became our father, and we became adopted sons and daughters of the family, right? Chidi families. So we say to ourselves, Asha, we encourage ourselves from the example of Mami Mary, Mami Pa, and we seek to emulate her example. It is not about titles or big accomplishments, but we take courage and strength from the fact that you can sell Pa and touch so many lives and impact a life of service, a life of service in the church, service that is emulated and depicted by the life of Mami Stella and also our father, Father Denny. May that encourage us and strengthen us in our own journey as we move along. So on behalf of the family, on behalf of all of us, join us downstairs for a celebration of a life well lived. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening,
Father. I intentionally forgot my glasses so I don't have to look at your faces. Because I always keep people when I offer my words of thanks, so I just see blurry faces, and I just don't want to see your faces. Huh? But thank you all for coming tonight. It's been an honor, really, like the chairman has just said, to have you all gathered to witness the life of a woman who did ordinary things in extraordinary ways. And I'm really thrilled on behalf of my family. I know you see my mom all the time. You just saw my brother for the first time. We're not twins. I assure you that. I was going to say I'm older because I'm father, but it's actually older. But anyways, on behalf of the family, I would like to really express my heartfelt gratitude to each and every one of you for gathering here tonight. And especially when I look at all these priests on the altar, I'm like, wow. You know, just imagine the blessings, the gift to have all these priests at your prayers, at your funeral. And I just want to use this opportunity to introduce and thank them in a special way. I will start with our Deacon Paul. Deacon Paul, in about 2 months, I think, he's going to be called Father Paul. He's going to be a priest. He's studying, finishing up his studies in Baltimore, Maryland, originally from Kumo. You all know his twin brother, identical twin, who got ordained a priest last year. So there will be two priests in that family, you know. Then, of course, I don't actually need to thank Father Basil, because, I mean, we don't thank family for being at his, he's supposed to be here, this is funeral. So Father Basil said it. Father Bazi is cousins with my mom on the father's side, so that's why he knew all the stories, because they grew up with Mami Pap. So I'm sure he met Mami Pap even before I was born. So Father Bazi is pastor of a church in Charlotte, North Carolina, so he drove today to do this, to preach at this mass. And we thank Father Bazi so much for his wonderful witness he's given us. I remember myself and my little brothers always going up to him. When we were little, but I think I wasn't the one asking about priesthood. I think it was Fanda. But Fanda, could, yeah, he was.
about priesthood, but then I became a priest. So the Lord works in mysterious ways. So, so the next priest will be our Father Nixon Ambe. Thank you. Father is a Josephite priest. He's the rector of the seminary, of Josephite Seminary in Washington, D.C. So Father also gave us some Cameroon buddies being here with us in this community. And the next will be Father Kenichu Starr. I don't think he needs any introduction. He's a big brother, a very good friend, a mentor to a lot of us younger priests here in Maryland. He's pastor of St. Charles Borromeo in Baltimore. So Father Kenichus, thank you for all you do. And actually, Mami was at the dedication of my mom into the St. Jude's at his church. So he did the mass with St. Jude. So he actually got to meet Mami a few times, I would say. The next actually will be Father Justin Stieg. Justin is a priest from Buffalo, like myself, actually. So Father Justin got ordained a year before me. We were in seminary together. I actually remember when I was a deacon at his first mass. So Father Justin is studying canon law at Catholic University in Washington. And I told him about that I'm coming here for my grandma's funeral. And he said he's really going to be here. And Father Justin is very intrigued with our culture. Actually, he sent me a video of a Bamenda girl singing. And he loved the song. And some of you might know Lee Bianca, I think that's his name. And I got to listen to her from the front. Like, this is so cool. I've heard this song before. And so Father Justin is so in touch with there's this Lamb of God we sing. Have pity on us, Jesus. I remember singing in the seminary, he played it on the piano, and I was so moved. So a very good friend, very brilliant man. So Father Justin, thank you for being here. The next will be our Father Aloysius Bo, another wonderful priest who needs no introduction. He's always here with us. He's a very strong member of our community. Father Aloysius recently, about a few months ago, got installed as pastor of a parish in West Virginia. So he's in a different state, but he's still here. You know, he bilocates like myself. So thank you very much for that. So we have Father Joseph Franz. Also from the Diocese of Buffalo. Actually, this is his second time in the community. The first time was last year, he was a deacon. And he stood next to me like Deacon Paul. So in a few years, we'll be calling Father Paul as well. So Father Joe, also doing his father's studies in Baltimore. He got ordained last year. I had the wonderful honor of not only laying hands on him, but also vesting him at ordination. So he gave me that honor. Father Joe's been a very good friend ever since I was in college. We studied philosophy together. We were very involved in school. And then we journeyed through seminary. It's really such an honor to know this wonderful and loving man who's a priest friend. Thank you, Father Joe, for coming. And of course, you know, he came from the farthest distance from Cameroon, Father Matthias. Please pray for him. All he hears are gunshots. So, not mass shootings, but gunshots. So pray for him. And he was a member of our community when he was studying in Virginia, but I think he's here visiting, and Father Matthias, it's always wonderful to have you, especially when you guide our community on retreat and give us very wonderful spiritual insights. So thank you for coming tonight. So I'll introduce to you now Mami's parish priest here in Washington, Father Cornelius. Because he's Mami's parish priest here in America. So Mami went to his church at St. Luke's in Washington. So he's also a Josephite priest, but he's also a very active member of our community. He's very involved here when he comes for different occasions and funerals. Father Cornelius, like other Nigerian priests we've had here, they just teach us that Africa is one. Really, yes. Teach us that Africa is one. So thank you very much. Talking about Africa being one, we have Father Pius, and we're actually here at his home because he works here. So Father Pius is a Dominican priest. priest, so he's a friar, a religious priest. When I look at him, I think of St. Thomas Aquinas, and I only think of Latin. That's probably why I did the Mass in Latin. So, Father Pius, thank you for being here. Awesome. When I was talking about Buffalo, you know, when Mami came to the U.S., Mami had that opportunity to see me as a priest. And I was so blessed to have Mami come up all the way to Buffalo. But given my priestly schedules and everything, Mami found herself a new family that really took care of Mami for one full week, nonstop. And even the last time I spoke on the phone with her, she kept asking me, how is Auntie Queen? Auntie Queen, how is Auntie Queen? So if Auntie Queen is here, we came together from Buffalo, please stand. And I just want to offer you heartfelt gratitude. Looking at Arai sitting on the other side, I think, yeah, that's Auntie Queen's daughter. So Mami got to live with them for a week, got to really know them, and was very close, attached to them. And it's really an honor that we are gathered here to celebrate this Mass. Thank you, especially to my wonderful Holy Trinity Choir, the Always Deliver. Make sure you sing Oye after this Mass. So they did a tremendous job when I became a deacon in Buffalo. And a lot of people were asking, like, wow, Father Denny, or at the time Deacon Denny, is your choir? Wow, they sang at the Basilica, it was moving. I even saw someone crying in church because Holy Trinity Choir sang. So if you have anything coming up, if you have weddings or funerals and you want to spice it up, especially from this community, please let us, the Holy Trinity Choir, know to come pray with you. For our motto is singing once, is praying twice. Quid cantat orat bis, from St. Augustine. So thank you very much. And I cannot stop thanking, rendering immense thanks to our CWO Mama and CWA Mamas. The CWO Mamas in this community have been my mothers from day one. When I look at your face, it brings me so much joy. You know, it brings me so much joy. And please, you know of my prayers for you, know of my heartfelt gratitude to each and every one of you, St. Jude, and you know, your spiritual in the mood, Mama, and I'm pretty sure she's in the kingdom of heaven. Sorry, I forgot Father Maurice, actually. How can I forget the chief shepherd? Okay. If there's any priest, Cameroonian priest that's known in Maryland, it's Father Maurice. So he needs no introduction, but I just want to also offer heartfelt gratitude. He came to my ordinations, and was very impactful, you know, making sure everything's going okay. So I really thank you for your fatherly role, not just to this community, but to us priests. God bless you, Father. Thank you. In 2013, Pope Francis granted an interview, and he was asked, he was asked a question about the Blessed Mother. And Pope Francis says, if you want to know about the Blessed Mother, ask the theologian. But if you want to know the Blessed Mother, ask the ordinary Christian devoted to her, praying to her every day. And when I read that, I remember thinking of my grandmother. She's not a theologian, but I bet you she knows Mary more than the greatest Mariologist in this world. On that note, I'd like to invite my brother priest for us to sing the Salve Regina, because I think, actually I learned the rosary from my grandmother, because she would take me to church every single day, even when I did not want to, even when I told her, Mommy, I'm not Catholic, I'm Presbyterian. She said, Mommy, can you stay with me as we go to Catholic church? So she was very instrumental in forming me, so I'd like to invite my brother priest if we can just stand on just the priest and pray to sing the Salve Regina. Thank you.
Salve Regina, Mater
Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
In te missa est.
Deo gratias.
Thank you. coming in today to make us know that more. And we know that our mother lived the motto of the youth: prayer, action, and sacrifice. So all what they say, live that moment. So we are here to pray. My sister is crying because she's not doing crime because we are expecting her. She's a new person to this group. Today, our new man comes. She's still new in this club. I know. But our mother is the same also. When she was praying, God answered.
Thank you, CWA. Now what?
can't stop making noise, but I'm going to try to talk over the noise. Father, Master,
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ma bola, Constitution, dans la région d'Ile-Digne, Bétigne. Dans cette association, nous sommes ensemble avec les Muslim Women Association, dont nos femmes. Alors, nous avons érigé un programme d'assistance des aides qui date de plus longtemps que nous avons créé cette association. Et ça marche très bien. Alors, ce soir, vraiment, nous regrettons avoir perdu l'une de nos membres, Maman Marie. Et pour la raison qu'elle s'est associée dans ce fonds et contribue également, aujourd'hui, c'est la récolte de ce qu'elle a fait pendant sa vie. Donc, pouvons dire à tous ceux qui sont ici que vous soyez au Cameroun dans la réunion ou pas, vous avez l'opportunité de venir vous inscrire dans ce programme. Parce que pendant qu'on vit, on prépare sa mort. Donc aujourd'hui, nous vous présentons un chèque symbolique que nous allons remettre. Oui. Un chèque symbolique de 10 000 dollars que nous allons remettre à la famille. Bravo, on prend et ça va marcher pour la banque. Merci beaucoup d'être ici ce soir avec nous pour pleurer notre moment parti.
Merci, merci. Applaudissez pour lui, les têtes de main. Laissez-la pour la prise, laissez-la pour la. Thank you. Thank you. So now I'm going to call the Kosne, please. Put the get ready. Put the please get ready. Kosne is coming next. Put the get ready. Thank you. Hello. Come and join Stella here, please. Come in Maryland. Mami was a member. All the members come in Maryland, please.
Come in Maryland,
come in Maryland, please. Come in Maryland.
Mr. Rindega, you don't know your post, fire.
So, why would you go come in Maryland? Mami was a member and a postnet. So I'm calling members of our postnet. You are registered member in this prestigious organization. So we need you all here, please. So on the right, you have I would just say Mr. Bertrand. He is a member of the Financial Bureau. He signs the check. And Mr. Jean Gobert is in the administration. He's in charge of all the paperwork to do. And myself, Mr. Dominic, I'm in the advisory board. So, even in Coastnet, we have a beneficiary that we always give for our members. And the result is to help to our federal program. And right as we are saying, since Mami was a member, he's entitled to $15,000. And Costa will present to Mami to stand up today. And a symbolic check will be given when the rich check will come. And from May 1st, Costa will be issuing at $20,000 in every member night. So they'll have $20,000. Let me hand it to, I'll hand this now to the Financial Bureau member, Mr. Bertrand.
Hello, everyone. Bonsoir, tout le monde. Est-ce que les connus vous m'avez dans la salle? Voilà. Cosnet, c'est une mutuelle d'obstacles créée depuis 2016, qui compte 6 000 membres dans tous les États-Unis. 6 000 membres. Ce n'est pas une affaire du village, c'est une affaire de tous les Camerounais. Tous les Camerounais, nous ne voulons pas savoir de quel village tu es, nous ne voulons pas savoir de quelle religion, nous ne voulons pas savoir ton sexe. ce que nous voulons savoir, c'est que tu sois Camerounais. Et depuis le mois de mars, on a élargi COSNEC aux Africains. Il y a 22 pays africains qui peuvent joindre COSNEC. De 2016 à aujourd'hui, nous avons déjà levé plus d'un million de dollars. Nous avons déjà aidé plus de 50 familles. Et comme Dominique a dit tout à l'heure, à partir du 1er mai, parce que quand nous avons mis COSNEC sur pied en 2016, notre objectif final, c'est de payer 30 000 dollars par un Camerounais donc aux États-Unis. À partir du 1er mai, nous allons partir à 20 000 dollars. Donc tout membre de COSNEC qui tombe à partir du 1er mai 2023, c'est 20 000 dollars que COSNEC donne. Donc aujourd'hui, de façon symbolique, nous voulons remettre officiellement à l'association Polymère là, un chèque symbolique de 15 000 dollars. 15 000 dollars pour le compte de Maman Marie. Nous faisons ça à toutes les veillées de nos membres. Nous sommes un non-profit organisation pour aider vraiment la communauté. Et aujourd'hui, quand un membre de COSNEC tombe, COSNEC, dès que vous fournissez l'acte de décès, COSNEC vous donne d'abord 10 000 dollars dans vos poches avant les contributions. 10 000 dollars. Et quand nous finissons de lever les contributions, nous faisons le reliquat, nous donnons le reliquat. Parce que l'objectif de COSNEC à long terme, c'est que quand un Camerounais ou un membre tombe, que nous serons capables de mettre les mains dans nos poches, on paye le membre avant de le récupérer après. Donc nous avons déjà atteint cet objectif à plus de 75%. Et nous pensons que si nous continuons, si les Camerounais continuent à nous faire confiance, d'ici 2 ans, 3 ans, on sera capable d'atteindre nos objectifs. Nous vous remercions pour votre attention. Nous serons derrière. Pour ceux qui ne sont pas encore à COSNEC, c'est une opportunité pour vous ce soir de joindre COSNEC. Quand vous joignez COSNEC, ce n'est pas pour vous. C'est pour votre mari, c'est pour votre épouse, c'est pour votre famille, c'est pas pour vous. Donc quand vous joignez, c'est par amour pour les uns que vous allez laisser. Par exemple, le cas de maman, c'est elle a allégé la tâche à la famille.
And please, an advantage of them is you have individuals. If you are not in any group, you want to join COSNEC as an individual, you are free. Just meet us behind there and I'll register you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's give a hand of applause for them. Thank you. Thank you.
Bootka, are you ready? DJ, can you
put
the music from Bootka?
Bootka, do you guys have a particular music or something?
Thank you.
hear. So, the Uber, I tell her,
thank you so very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. So, at this thank you.
Eventful. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
third term of this meeting, because we're going to hear from Master while all the congregation are standing there. Please give a word of thanks to everybody that has come here today to celebrate Mami's life with you. So, please, everybody to stop the noise. Can I get some calm in this building? Guys, please, I beg for your attention, please. Gentlemen. Okay, some people live in their home and they come from me, they still talk. I beg no one, I keep when I know it's not small. Make Mami Stella actually attack everybody. Then we just start make noise. I want the microphone is here.
Hello.
Hi.
It's hot. It's really, really hot. It's hot. It's really, really hot. I tried to breathe, but I think my voice is all baby. Everyone who made it possible in one way or the other to be here today, and each one who came, who passed by me, called me, sent me text messages, I do appreciate you all. I think my mom left a legacy, and the legacy I think I will try to emulate. That smile is somebody who at any time in her life you come beside her, she smiles. She never frowns. Even if she's angry, you will never know. Even though they say Mami Pap, really, we don't really know her as our mother. There are people who know her as their mother. She didn't raise only eight, she raised thousands, and people have testimonies on that. And inside the park, she produced a lawyer, an accountant, all inside that park, mothers, engineers, and why not a grandson who is a priest.
Amen.
Mama has tried, for her age, she has really, really tried. It's just that it is hard. It's really, really hard. Some of you know what I'm going through, and some don't know what I'm going through now. And to cut a long story short, I thank all of you, I thank everyone in the house, and I pray the good Lord bind the eyes, blind the eyes of the devil, blind the eyes of the policeman, because you have drunk a lot. Open your eyes and you drive home safely and meet your families. I ask all this in the mighty name of Jesus I have prayed.
Amen.
Lord, there is nothing else I can say. Thank you for giving me a mother who could withstand everything. Truly speaking, I don't think some of us today can make eight children. I mean, understand that our parents did it. So, my father, I can say he died about 25 years ago, but my mom could still withstand all the problems we were giving her. I was about to go home in December last year. I bought my ticket. I and my eight brothers, my seven brothers, we had three girls, five boys. My sister passed. So we are just two girls now. And five boys. So we said we're gonna have our own meeting, only the kids. I said, okay, Mama, as I'm going, you go and stay, you have a caregiver, you stay. He said, no, I'm going to stay with Father. He said it in the morning. I said, oh, I'll go to school, Father. I'll stay with Father. Okay, if I'm going to be one more, I'll stay with Father. I said, okay. I bought my ticket. In the evening, I came back. He said, oh, no, I don't think I'll go to Father. All of us will go to that campground. I said, Mama, campground, they're not just going behind the house or just go on that plantain, go campground. She said, I know it's expensive. If you want to, I give you money. I have money. I said, do you have money? He said, yes, I have people who have money. I said, okay, so you are making amount. Me too, I'm one of the people, I'll buy it. Guess what? I bought a ticket for $4,000 in December for both of us. Very expensive. That was a round ticket. Little did I know my mother was going like that not to come back. So we went home, all went well. I left her, I said, okay. If you need me, I'll come back to take you when you have your ticket open. Anything I want to come back, she said, oh, down a country. The only thing that is driving me in that country is cold. It's so cold. I said, my baby, you come when it's hot time. She said, yes. I said, it's not cold time. She said, yes. She said, you come during summer. It's not yet summer. She took my air ticket to another place. So, well, all I can say, Mama, you fought a good fight, fought your race, and you won your race at the end. You tried your best, and you ate something. She lived a bonus life. And I was going home, lay her rest, where we meet, all of us are going, because nobody wants to stay behind. So I will go home, lay her, the village. She's from Bana. She got married to a Bangateman. Balengu. Bangena, but the parents said to Balengu. So we're going to go very hard in Balengu, where we can have been very their family. Very hard. I think the only person that will not bury in Balengu was Bangateman is me, because I'm married out there. Thank you all. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for coming. Stay blessed. May you Lord bless you all. And all who I saw on the table and thank those who cooked those food. May the Almighty God replenish your source. Let it replenish your source in 100-fold. And thank you for coming. Thank you for eating. And thank you for eating because you may cook and you don't eat. And thank you for drinking. You may buy the drink and you don't drink. And thank you all for eating and thank you all for drinking. And no food stays here, all food goes to me. Please, I have to go back. I have to go carry out. All that food have to leave because my mother left legacy of feeding. She doesn't discriminate children she feeds. I can start talking from now to tomorrow. I thank you so much.
Thank you. It's been wonderful now. DJ, you can go to music at this end of the evening. You can dance. Now you can even dance some more.
Chance.